Hello, my name is Abe and welcome to Blueprints House Tour. This was recommended to me by a personal friend who thought that I might be interested. I think this is a puzzle type of experience, first person puzzle game. Not really like an escape room, but I don't know, maybe it is like an escape room, I don't know. We'll check it out. This is the demo from the Steam Next Fest. Let's new game it. Loading. Blueprints. Loading. Take a drink. I can't help but in my own head right now just go like, okay, yep, get on with it. Insert scene from Monty Python. Get on with it!
Get on with it!
Yes! Get on with it!
Hereby revoke all wills and codicils heretofore made by me. I give and bequeath to my grandnephew, Simon P. Jones, son of my dear niece, Mary Matthew, all of my right, title, and interest in and to the house and land which I own near Mount Holly. The above provision and bequest is contingent on my aforementioned grandnephew discovering the location of the 46th room of my 45 room estate. The location of the room has been kept a secret from all the staff and servants of the manor, but I am confident that any heir worthy of the Sinclair legacy should have no trouble uncovering its whereabouts within a timely manner. Should my grandnephew fail to uncover this room or provide proof of his discovery to the executors of my will, then this gift shall lapse. In witness whereof, I have hereunto set my hand this 8th day of March, 1993. Herbert S. Sinclair.
I was really thinking it would be like 1561. No, this is a modern house. It's got plumbing. It's got electricity. It's got everything. Day one of the blueprints. We see the prince in his natural habitat. A rich manor house and mansion estate. 4 days. Pre-release house tour. A humble preview. I have no idea what to really expect, but why don't we immediately run outside. Faucet doesn't have Wi-Fi. Oh no. Can I jump? I cannot jump. All right. So I don't know what to really expect, except that this is just a puzzle game of some sort. I don't know what the puzzles are really themed around or anything. That looks like a star in a mountain. That's a really weird looking mountain. That's not normal geological activity. That's an evil lair. That's a scientist's evil lair. 100%. That is not how mountains work. What happens if we just jump off? Can't. Blueprints, blueprints, says Quark. Shake my head. That's the Darkest Dungeon 2 mountain. You know what? I believe it. That does look like the Darkest Dungeon 2 mountain. Well, there's nothing over here. Why let me explore over here if there's nothing over here? But there's probably nothing over here yet. Because there is an entrance there as soon as we get the tire iron. Not the tire iron, the crowbar. Lots of bird fountains here. I'm literally just trying to break the game right now. Walking away from what you're supposed to be doing. We should probably actually do the proper mission objectives. In the top left corner, it looks like we have time. Campsite, due to the rule, and we are running out of time just by wandering around. You may call it a day at any time from the blueprint menu tab. Luckily, however, your scouting skills have been put to the use to fabricate a very respectable off-site sleeping quarters. So I'm going to spend a little bit of time wandering around. Guys, I want... How will I ever get to the orchard? How can I ever get to the orchard? I can almost reach the delicious apples in the orchard, but I can't quite get there. I don't even like hop the fence. you idiot. Bunker. Oh, you know what this is? I've actually discovered the secret of the mansion. The hidden 46th room. It's actually a biolab by Resident Evil. This is a not by Resident Evil, by Umbrella Corporation. If you see an umbrella symbol around, let me know. We need a screwdriver for the door. Ooh, that looked like a weird texture. It's always 0451. Why is it always 0451? Is that a running gag or something? All right. Open only in the event of my death. Yeah. No tools or items may be brought onto the estate. Can't take them off. Don't stay overnight. Don't assume that the rooms will be the same tomorrow. And we get a blueprint roll. A map. Tab. There's the entrance hall. The antechamber is in the back. We can call it a day at any time. Every first code lock in a game has to be 0451. Been that way since System Shock. The IMSIM number, says username. The immersive SIM number. Interesting. Each time you enter a room, you will lose 1 foot. When you no longer have foot, you're too tired, and you must call it a day. I didn't enter rooms, though. I was outside. Select a room to draft. So we get to actually put rooms around the estate. Let's put a hallway down, because... I was kind of hoping we could like get a window outside. That's not how that works, unfortunately. Now, if I go into the previous room, yeah, it does just count down every time we do it. And I'm looking, Queen of Diamonds, Ace of Spades. It looks like some of these rooms are gonna have hints, two puzzles, potentially. I believe that's probably part of the mechanics. For example, this is 8:45 on the clock. Hands grasping prayer bead, the crowbar, which I knew we were going to need. And it also looks like whenever you enter this room, gain 2 foots. It also looks like we might have the ability to... Well, there's 45 rooms, right? 5, 10, 15, 20, 25, 30, 35, 40, 45. You have to fill every square. 5, 10, 15, 20, 25, 30, 35, 40, 45. And somewhere there's going to be a door to the outside. That might be the antechamber. I don't know. The antechamber to the 46th room in the back. So... I'm like, can I cheese the system here a little bit? I don't know if you can actually cheese the system. It felt like I was actually able to get more feedback, but maybe you can't actually cheese it in that fashion. This is just a hand. It's very interesting. There's no, like, crouch. There is a run, interestingly enough. That's a giant chess piece. That's an onion. Paper crane. Is there really no, like, crouch? Maybe we don't need the box. Maybe we don't need the drawer. Like, there's nothing to interact with. Am I losing it? Room directory. Game settings. Controls. ER. E is use, R is room directory. Stroll is shift. And that's it. Okay. So these are all of the different rooms that we have seen. There's 46 rooms. Red rooms. Oh god, it's Twin Peaks. Okay, so where are we? We are in the bedroom. And we can draft these rooms here. I guess there has been a... Lose money? I guess there has been a, like a map that we're trying to build here. Put the chapel down next to the bedroom. That's where I would put it. There's another chess piece. Like, I can't... I definitely can't interact with anything, so it's not like I can grab the chess piece and bring it with me. I have a feeling that's going to be part of the puzzle at some point. Okay. Closet, utility closet, drawing room. You may draw new floor plans while drafting in this room. Requires a gem. Okay, let's just put a closet here then. Oh look, a gem. Also a coin bag. Each time you collect 3 coins, earn 1. Is this like a roguelite? Do we get like a random item? Moobler, thank you! He does exist! Well, guess we can put, like, the breaker box here. There's not, but we can put a storeroom here. One coin. We're gonna lose the coin walking into the chapel. Does that actually matter? I don't know. There's another pawn. Another painting, another gem, a key, a hammer. Shatter padlocks on locked trunks. So I guess the idea is that we're gonna be like backtracking through different rooms constantly trying to find all of the things that we need. It's like a little model of the house. What I really want is to grab... Here's the thing. If there is not a giant chess puzzle, I'm gonna be very disappointed that there's these chess pieces everywhere in this house. Makes no sense. And the bishop's right there. Nope. Okay. I'm trying to also cheese the heck out of the game systems here to get infinite moves, but I don't think that works, unfortunately. No. All right. This is blocked off because we put a closet there. It's like if Gungeon was a house, the walls are always shifting. Pretty much. I am curious what happens if we, like, completely block ourselves in. Because this pantry goes nowhere. It's like a flour mill or something? Kitchen timer. A banana. I got +3 speed. Bridget, please pick up some more fruit before Friday. As we have been informed, we maybe have an extra guest exploring the house. 50 steps should be more than enough, so I think an even spread should be ideal. 5 apples, 5 bananas, 5 oranges. Okay. They're not all in this room, right? Also, why can't I bring the ladder with me? That seems like it would make sense, right? Oh, I love cheese. Is there any cheese in that grater? Looked like I saw something up there for a second. Okay, keep going. I think we're gonna lock, if I make a bathroom, do we lock ourselves in? Let's see. Oh, hey, look at that. We've completely locked ourselves in. What now? I guess you leave and come back because it resets. Hold on. I think I'm beginning to see. Paperclip, tree. Well, who would have thought there wouldn't have been anything in the actual bathroom? So because we've blocked ourselves in, we have to end the day, come back tomorrow. Is that correct? We have a couple of items. We have to make it to the antechamber. And I suppose let's just click the button, see what happens. What's the point of calling it a day? That traffic cone, welcome. This is Blueprints, a game that was suggested to me. Rank reached, steps taken, items found. Okay. It's like a puzzle game. But I don't understand it yet. You're a tiny lad. I need to eat my banana so I can walk further. Magical, mystical house is it that it gets reset every day? So here's the ultimate question. Can we put a hallway here again? It looks different. Rank seems to be the rows you've managed to reach. Rank 3. Get a room on row 3, says Connie. Okay, I can see that. Type permanent blueprint. So these are all the different rooms that we've seen. Type blueprint dead end. On entry, it gives you something. It's a common room. Red room. So red rooms are negative rooms. Like, this doesn't give you anything. Green rooms are probably like very positive rooms, and a hallway is just a hallway room. This is the objective. Okay, I'm starting to understand. The puzzle is part picking up items along the way that could help you, and part, looks like there's something there, that's just lighting, trying to manipulate the board state to get you further. Billiard room. As I always enjoyed your mathematical puzzles and appreciated that didn't need to know the rules or point values to play your variations. New game in the billiard room. Now we know that there's a game in the billiard room, maybe? I don't know, but we can put a den here. I don't know if we can rotate the rooms when we put them down. Is a moving clock? Is this the actual time? No. What is the actual time? 9:08. What the freaking chess pieces everywhere, man? The trunk is locked. That does not appear on the map, unfortunately. Let's, if there's nothing else in this room, maybe some wine? Maybe a gem? Let's go in here. Lavatory is a dead end, storeroom is also a dead end, but it gives you stuff. Spare room is a, looks like a hallway room, kind of. It's just got paint. What a room. What a room, what a room, what a mighty fine room. What a pantry? I think we can get behind the bed now. Yeah, we can get behind the guest bedroom. There's a app hole. Some money. 5 apples, 5 bananas, 5 orange. 55 apples, 55 bananas, 55 oranges! And here we can put a dead end. Experimental house features. Utility closet, lavatory. Let's put the utility closet in. We don't really need to put the bathroom in. Although, you know what? We're gonna have to put one of each room. So we have to plan out where the dead ends are gonna go. Like here. Keycard entry system. Off. Cabinet. Dark room, gymnasium. Dark room, we probably want to be off. Seems like what we also want. Oh, is this some weird puzzle? Like, you gotta get all of the lights blue, maybe? Don't do this to me, game. I don't wanna. What the heck? Get red and purple as well? You know what? This is not a puzzle for us right now. But we have turned off key card access to something. So yeah, so as you play, you're gonna learn what the different rooms are, what they do, where you need to go, what needs to be near where. You place bad dead end rooms, like maybe the lavatory down here, because you have to place red rooms, and you have to plan out your movement through the mansion. So here, a nook means we can move to the left. As you continue, you may want to consider getting something to scribble your notes down. A pad. Prove useful. Okay. I don't have a pad. Found a key, which is a generic key. There's a rook. I don't know why. We'll get to that when we do the chess puzzle, I assume. Plus one star for each time you've drafted observatory. What the heck is a star? Corridor is always left unlocked. So, if we put a room here that's locked, it'll be unlocked. Put the parlor down, I guess? Well, let's explore the room real quick. See if there's anything in here that we're missing. There's a hat. There's a lockbox in the den. You know, you're not wrong. I'm glad someone's paying attention. It's gonna cost us a few rooms, but if we had the sledgehammer, I think we could have just broken it. Lockpick. We'll occasionally be able to open some doors. Draft says as a tip, when you draft, you can see how the room is going to look on the map. I didn't know that. I didn't notice that. Got a wind-up key. Blah, 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 blah. Games. Always be at least one box which displays only true, only false. Only one box has a prize within. The other two are always empty. At least one box. Oh my god. Well, I mean, I understand the puzzle already. I just don't like it. The statement on the white box is true. There's a second wind-up key in this room. This box and the white box are both empty. Only one box is a prize within. This box and the white box are both empty. Meaning the item's here or the item is here and here. Both empty, both empty, both empty. So either there's an item here, here, or here. If the item is here or here, we don't know which one it is because the statements don't actually allow us to tell that. So the item has to be here, I think. That could be faulty logic, but my brain is immediately saying go here, right? Because the only statement regarding things in boxes is this one. If there's an item here or here, well, which one? So it has to be this one. So you don't even have to, like, care about these two boxes at all. They're statements anyways. Which, statement on the white box is true. So this one's false. There's a second wind-up key in the room, and it's true. False, false, true, 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 false, error, false, true, error. So I think there's also a second wind-up key in the room. So we look for a minute, we can probably find it, unless we need like a wrench to open a door that allows us to grab it or something. Oh yeah, you're right. This is a true box, not a false box. I'm a dummy. Okay, never mind. The door's locked. I locked it. I unlocked it. So you're right. It actually does show you. I see you approach from the bottom every time. Nifty. Okay, so let's move off to the right. Don't know. Don't know. There's like nothing in this room. So, this should just really be open all the time, let's be honest. Each day a meal is served here after rank 8 has been reached, plus 1 for each time you've drafted observatory. I mean, let's do the dining room. I want to keep going forward. But something tells me at some point we're going to have to actually move to the side a bit. You may draw new floor plans while drafting this room. I think I've already screwed it up because that was the drafting, wasn't it? Yeah, this is the, yeah, okay. I've already screwed up the mechanic of the room, I think. I'm supposed to interact with it before I click the button. Each time you click on a door, you will draw the 3 floor plans. There are some items and rooms that will allow you to redraw if you do not like your initial option. Oh no, okay, I see. Thank you, thank you. You've explained it to me. I can redraw. I don't like these. Redraw. You cannot see the floor plan drafting in that room. View inventory of all items currently in the house. That seems pretty nice. A little overly dramatic game. Lockpick is going crazy today. Also, I have a face. But that's not me. Actually, this is exactly what I look like, IRL. I am an anime protagonist. Actually, I'm a background character in an anime protagonist film. Yes, yes. I know this is here, game. I drafted the room. Trying to be super dramatic about it. My God, this exceptionally expensive rich person's mansion has a security system. Good job. Well, that was just a complete waste of time. So what the hell is this room? Inventory of all items currently in the house? What do you mean, view inventory? How can I view my inventory? Or is this just all of the rooms that have items? Yo, my shadow looks real weird in that picture. There's a microwave, if I want to make myself a sandwich. Someone got their film degree, says Connie. Yeah. There's a horse. Oh, there we go. Okay. Keycard systems. It's offline. Change offline mode. Determines the default setting the security doors will be if the power is locked. Yeah, please go offline. Thank you. Now all security doors are done. The amount of keycard security doors will be deployed. You should expect to see one or two security doors with low. Okay, well, there you go. Return. View estate inventory. Currently in the house that have yet to be collected, 000. We're very good. And then there was a login. I guess we can try the login. Yes. Login to the network. Password. 0451. Incorrect password. All right, well. Why do I have to hit exit before I stand up? All right, let's make a room that goes left if we can. You can't seem to be able to pick this door. Well, that's okay. How about this door? We want a passageway seems pretty good. This room counts as two bedrooms, bunk room. Why? Gym requirements. Once you have drawn four floor plans, you must select one. Well, I guess we're doing chapel then. It does go to the right. Try password, try admin. I'm not gonna log back in. Honestly, screw that noise. Okay. Any coins under the pews? It seems like, by the way, drafting that room has given us music now. Can't pick the door. So we can go this way, potentially. Ah! Milk jug, thank you very much for the resub. How are you doing today? Oh my gird. Ka-ka. It doesn't show on the screen, but it is there. Thank you. How you doing? Heating and cooling curves for water's melting point at parts per temperature, complete thaw, room temperature, melting point. Okay. Like 18 degrees complete thaw. Science? Science. Fake science. 3, 8, 12, 2, 9, 11, 10, 5, 6, 1, 7, 4. Do you think this is the passcode for the computer or something? Oh, wait. 1 through 12, 1 through 10. The machine requires additional power piped in from the boiler room, so we have to draft a boiler room. Got a computer console. Oh my god. Honestly, no. I don't have the energy to go through the entire computer system, okay? It's like the floor plan to draft. It's gonna put a just a garbage closet here. Look at this garbage closet. Alright, thanks. Alright, well, let's go back to the drawing room and see if we can't make some waves. Can't lockpick the door. God damn it. So you enter from the bottom, right? Food for sale. Let's get some gems. Ding, ding, ding. Ding, ding, ding. All right, good room. Draft, you have a good night. I think we're done. Like, I don't have keys. Locked, don't have keys. Well, where's the dining room? Oh, I'm in the dining room. Meal? Meal? I don't know. I guess we could just like go outside and take a look around. Oh, this was the parlor game, wasn't it? Yeah. I see. The parlor's got a game. Entrance right. No, cause. That's locked. Yeah, okay, entrance. Going back. Unless this was, no, this is not locked. This is an unlocked room. Whenever you draft a bedroom, gain 5 feet. Opportunity to earn and spend money. Well, we have to draft. No matter what we draft, we're stuck. So, give me the storeroom, because maybe a key allows us to keep going. If that's a room key, and we can use it on a door? Because if the sledgehammer could have opened the padlock, we could have saved a key, and maybe we can actually use this key up here by, like, the security room. So where are we? We're currently in the dining room. Let's go one more. And one more. Use a key. So now we can add a gymnasium. So we can go left. Like some mouse smoothing happening? Oh my god, there is, isn't there? You can't change it though. Maybe there isn't. Kind of feels like there's weird mouse smoothing happening. This is a security door, but it's unlocked. So let's put in a check one item and retrieve it on another day. Dark room allows us to go left, but we can't see. I turned the lights off. Yeah. Bit of a mistake on my part now that I think about it. It is a dark room after all. Let's see what Let's see what we're drafting here. I've got gems. Observatory. It's a dead end! No, that way. Fine. Come on, kid, you can step up there. I don't know what I'm doing. Hold on, do we turn this now? Nope. Another freaking chess piece. The fixed stars. Depending on the number of stars, different constellation of various sizes can be visible. North Star, 1 gold. Twins. 2 trunks have been added to the entrance hall. The slice plus 3 steps. Plus 1 gem. Rooms with 4 doors are more common today. Plus 1 key. Apples are extra delicious. Plus 5 gems. Dead-end rooms are more common. Everything is half off. Green rooms are more likely to contain special flowers. 20, 15. So, it says you get 1 more star for each time you've drafted it. What we do with that, I'm not certain. But like, I can't actually, hold on. Get up the steps. You dumb kid. Can I interact with this wheel now? I can block my way. Wait, the side that you spin this thing is whether it moves up or down. Okay, hold on. I think I see. Spin it to the right. Aha! Yes. North Star gain 2 gold because we only have 1 star? So on different days, different things can happen depending on how many of those star points you have. Star points! Alright, well, hopefully we don't brick it on this side. We didn't brick it! I saw that. There was a El Chupacabra over there. Occasionally, you may discover small mounds of dirt. With a shovel, one may be able to excavate those suspicious piles. What? You mean... Okay. Well, do I have a shovel? Oh, I need a freaking key now! Methinks we're almost due. Oh my god, I need another freaking key. We're out of keys. I have 6 gems, which don't really do anything for me. Parlor, corridor. I wonder if we can actually make it down there in time. Before we pass out from exhaustion. Ugh. Been walking forever. Actually, never mind. We've already done something in this room. Never mind. We're screwed, man. We're screwed, man. What are we gonna do, man? What are we gonna do? I mean, literally, there's a big hole in it. You could just jump through it. Sorry, this kid, though, he's too, make a wish. This kid's too prim and proper for, jumping fences. That's not what he does. Jump a fence? Are you kidding me? I could get my pants dirty. Mama would be very displeased. I guess we have not opened that yet. Oh, 4, 5, 1. I tried. Mission failed. All right. End me. Take me away. I passed out. The house might be a little different. What do you mean a little different? I thought it was supposed to be completely changed. And we are now broke because we lose all of our stuff. I mean, I feel like... Okay, so the idea is that you have to place all 45 rooms, I think. The antechambers and the entrance hall make rooms 1 and 2. And then probably that's what unlocks the final hallway. Or you just have to make it to the antechamber, in which case it seems like it's just random as to whether or not you're going to get there. Like, you can make it easier depending on the items you get and the luck of the room draw, but like, we just found a bunch of locked doors and the lockpicks didn't work. If they did work, we could have gotten in. Right? I don't think that would have actually solved the puzzle. I think the puzzle is try to get all rooms on the map somehow, which means you have to put rooms in all of the dead ends. Or rather, put all the dead ends in the proper dead end locations. Whether that's actually correct, I don't know. And yeah, everything is just totally different, but we do have one star. And, wasn't there, like... There was something like you only had 4 days to do it, so if you fail, you probably have to just start back from the beginning, right? Hold on. House history. Day 1. Day 2. It even looks different here, which is interesting. Okay. This is the same. I don't know, make another toilet? 4 days in the demo, says Connie, probably more in the full game. I think, while that's possible, I think actually they're just trying to go for a puzzle where you can solve this in 4 days by learning all of the information that you need from the first 3 days. It's kind of like Mastermind. You know, how many are right? How many are wrong? Which ones are in the right position or whatnot? With a little bit of information, you can solve the puzzle. I wonder if that's more of the style of what they're going for, but I don't know. Billiard room. Can you play billiards with these balls? They're not even spheres. Can I, like, pick up a dart? Nope. I can click on it and then not do anything. Pretty sure it explicitly mentions you've been giving 4 days in the demo. I mean, I suppose it could just progress infinitely, but I think this says 4 days. Well, it said it in the intro sequence, right? In a specific number of time, you should be able to find this. 4 days should be enough. Didn't it say something like that? Or am I losing my mind? I could be losing my mind. Well, let's just see if we can't, like, brute force it to the end. This box is the middle box. The gems are in the middle box. This box is the middle box. Which one do you think is telling the truth, and which one do you think is a lie? I don't know. That's a tough one. That's a toughie. I don't know, man. I don't know. This box is the middle box. The gems are in the middle box. I mean, the gems could be in the middle box. If this is the middle box, they're in the middle box. But if this one's the middle box, it could be in the middle box. This one's the one that's lying. This is like an AI-generated puzzle. That's what it is. You know what? Sure, give me a key. I will say, one thing about this game that I'm really not a fan of, there's some weirdness with the movement. Like, the camera movement, it has a little bit of a slide to it. It doesn't snap. Makes me a little bit nauseous. So I kind of wish that wasn't a thing. But it's trying to, like, smooth the mouse look, and as a result, it's just making it look a little awkward. We can go this way. Sorry, not look awkward, it's making it feel awkward. It doesn't specifically mention it's a demo thing, but it's welcome to the house tour with all the pre-release disclaimers. Screen says you've been granted 4 days. I think that's just part of the puzzle, honestly. I don't think it's an issue with the fact that it's a demo. I think it's just part of the puzzle is that you have 4 days. Alright, so this room, we get to redraw rooms. Put in a nook for a key. I want to make it to the antechamber and just see if there's like a hint there. Because I feel like if my suspicion is correct, and this is a room where, sorry, this is a game where you're going to have to actually play through numerous times to discover all of the secrets that you need in order to get through, then I want to see if there's some information at the end that we're going to need. That's fine. 4 days to discover, experience, explore before your official bequest begins. What? Food for sale. Sure. You know, I'm honestly, we're not backtracking. Den Observatory Wine Cellar. We don't have any gems. We need gems so we can keep, like, constructing these rooms. Well, we have to play the Oh, we can't play the passageway. Okay. Well, in that case. Come in here real quick. We can go this way still. Boudoir! I do love me a good boudoir. Okay, well, we're gonna have to, like, loop around a little bit. What a lovely boudoir! Like, some of these rooms don't even seem like they have anything in them. Sure, give me a dark room. Shouldn't the lights have been on? There's pieces of paper here, I can't see them anymore. An upstairs patio, the terrace. Green rooms do not cost money to draft. Hey, actually, we do have the shovel. If we can bash some zombie heads in with the shovel. Where are we going? We're going left. And we're getting poor every time. Turn it. Well, I was kind of hoping for something a little bit better than that. Like an item. Coins. Eh. Yeah, bash the lock in with the shovel. All right. So this is Blueprints. Again, I'm not entirely certain why there's the 4-day limit. I think all of your progress will get reset at that point, but that also might not be the case because the observatory does have a maximum of 20 stars for a reward, and you get plus one every time you draft the room. So theoretically, you would get 1, 3, 6, 10, right? And if you're drafting it every day for 4 days, that's not enough to get that 20 value. Unless, for some reason, stars rolls over between runs, but that doesn't really make a lot of sense. So theoretically, the 4-day limit is actually a limit for the demo, potentially. But it seems like I look at this and I'm like, okay, what do I do here? I can't really do anything. But the more that I learn about the rooms, like the fact that, oh, the shovel's in the terrace, you get 2 gems from the parlor, you get, I know you get a key from the nook, but you get a gem in the guest bedroom, and being able to kind of like more better plan out where you want the rooms to be by knowing what rooms exist in the room pool, because there are rooms. It's gems in each green room. I feel like if you play a lot of this, you'll actually start to understand the layout for the rooms, right? Although actually, having said that, bedrooms, hallways, green rooms, shops, and red rooms are not rooms. There's actually more than 45 rooms. There's, I don't know where room one is, but there's these 46 rooms. And then on top of that, bedrooms, hallways, green rooms, shops, and red rooms. So there's actually way more than 46 rooms. So maybe my assumption that you have to place every room is actually incorrect. Maybe you don't have to actually place every unique room. You might still have to fill up all 45 squares here, but it's not like literally a puzzle with 45 pieces. There's actually 60 pieces or 70, 80 pieces, and you still have, but you might still have to complete the puzzle. I don't know. In any case, blueprints, if you like puzzle games and you like first-person puzzle games, maybe you should be checking out a little bit of blueprints. Freezer freezes your accounts. Money and gems will not be reset. That's kind of interesting. You know what? Let's do that, and then let's, oh, yeah. Rip. People have not used this freezer for a long time. Let's call it a day, see what happens on the final day. And if that doesn't do it, we'll call it a day again and see what the game over at least looks like. Yep, that was my day. We should have one more day to do it, because it said you had 4 days. So this is the fourth day, and at the end of this day will be the game over. And we'll know if it's actually like a demo thing or not, because it should probably say, thank you for playing. In the real version, you'll have more days or whatnot. So let me open up one room just to make sure that we have something for the game to not complain about. Because it might complain. Probably not, but you never know. Yo. And then call it a day. Steam has disconnected? That's weird. Milkjug says, I went and ate cake, did some spreadsheets, and you're still doing this game. I'm just playing the demo. And I've only been playing it for 62 minutes. Someone mentioned the Nuclear Throne inspired game, says Milkjug. If no one has, so if there is one, you check me out. You check me out? You send me a message about that and let me know. Did it freeze? The freezer got him. Did my stream freeze? That's very unfortunate if that's the case. Thanks for visiting. That might be why my Steam froze, because the game froze. It's not a storm. As the house tour concluded, Simon strode off. But was that, like, so is it 4 days because it's the demo, or 4 days because you're only gonna get 4 days? I don't know. Oh, it totally just ended. Very interesting. Okay, well, in that case, there you go. That's blueprints. I gotta figure out why my stream died. For those of you on YouTube, thank you very much for watching. Like the video if you've enjoyed it. Subscribe for more. Check me out on Twitch for when I go live. Support the channel at the various links below in the video description. And I hope to see you here again for the next Let's Look At.